And then we will come back again to this topic later. Sofia, please, all yours.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. First of all, I'm very much different from the fields you are in, most of you, because I'm from entertainment industry, but I was introduced as Sofia and Taste of India. Well, Taste of India actually belongs to my business partner who is here right now, Harbinder Dutt Singh. And I'm doing brand marketing over there. But we have another company, Under One Sky Entertainment, which brings people from India and Dubai to Georgia to shoot music videos, TV commercials, do events. Before coronavirus, we used to celebrate holy festivals, Diwali, Republic Day, and we used to bring really huge stars from India, like Rakesh Roshan, Jitendra Ji, whoever is from India, they know how huge and big names these are and what are these, you know, who are these people. But right now, due to this situation, whatever is happening, it's impossible to plan anything at all. Sadly, I have not prepared presentation, which is why I will be just introducing to you verbally what we are doing. This year, during pandemic, we brought 3 music videos from Dubai, which was not an easy task. Even from India, there are a lot of people who are willing to come to Georgia, but it's impossible. I'll tell you why. They cannot get visa. Even e-visa, electronic visa, which is there on our website, they are not able to register there and come to Georgia. Therefore, they choose Armenia to go there and shoot music videos, TV commercials, and even films. Now imagine how much money Georgia is losing just only because they are not able to get visas. And my connections, my friends, my close friends who are into this industry, they're not able to come to Georgia. Even though they love this country, I'm trying to promote Georgia through my social media. I have 95,000 followers on Instagram, and I'm promoting Georgia on my level best. 3 days ago, we had a premiere of this song. We invited huge celebrities, not celebrities, social media celebrities, and they've been promoting it. But all my effort and work is useless unless and until our government solves this problem. I don't know exactly, and I don't want to assume things. I just don't know what is the result behind all this, but Indians are not getting visa anymore in Georgia, which is why we are now focusing on Indians living in Dubai. And even I'm not talking about governments or politics. I'm just saying the facts, whatever is happening in this industry, because it's not only about business. It's not only about studies. Entertainment industry can bring huge money in Georgia, like biggest money in Georgia. Bollywood is second biggest. Actually, I think it's only first now. It's even bigger than Hollywood because they are shooting 1,000 film every year. And even in Moscow right now, biggest stars of India, Varun Dhawan and Kiara Advani, they are in Moscow shooting film. And every film, guys, they spend millions of US dollars. And imagine how much money they could bring in Georgia. But because of the lack of information why Indians are not able to get visas, projects are going to other countries. So this is also a huge loss, and we have to pay attention to this also. That's just my point of view. And the name of the company, Under One Sky Entertainment, it just came that we are all living under one sky. And it doesn't matter what is the color of our skin, what's our sex, gender, like, it doesn't matter. We are all one, living under one sky. But sadly, the reality in this world is different. And now we are facing huge problems. And Georgia is now even having smaller, to say so, level on a world map than Armenia. Armenia is richer than Georgia, and Georgia was so much ahead like 10 years ago, for example. And my friends from all around the world, they used to talk about Georgia very highly and very respectfully. But since the last few years, this perception has changed, and we all know why. Even I myself don't feel safe in my country anymore, and not to mention celebrities or many other people who are watching news what is happening in Georgia. I think yes, freedom of the speech is important, but a strong hand is also very important in the country, so that whoever thinks whatever they think, it's not okay that everyone is free to do whatever they want. It's not okay. I mean, we all need a strict hand to be ruled and shown the right way and right path where to go and what to do. This is just my idea and my way of thinking. And that's all I would want to say and share with you. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Sofia, did you have some cases in the border that people come and they went back or something like that?
All this has started in 2017 when we shot Rocky Mantle song, and the producers wanted to come to Georgia. They wanted to shoot whole film in Georgia. It was a $2 million project. When we started really big noise we made around it, and people called me from television. Nodar Meladze, I think his name, and we just decided not to take it on that level, because again, we didn't want to make extra noise around it. That was my first experience. That is here, and he confirmed that these people has been deported. Then again, we paid from our pocket and invited these filmmakers to Georgia. Again, they were deported. There was opening of Biltmore's casino, Jewel, I'm sure you know.
Yeah, sure, we know.
We brought 18 people from India to celebrate Republic Day of India, which is 26th of January. And out of these 18 people, most of them were deported. Rakesh Roshan, Jitendra Ji, they came earlier. But the people who had to, you know, do show on the stage, these people were deported. Then I had to use my connections to bring these people in Georgia. So what I'm saying right now is that there is a monopoly. There are some companies who are allowed to bring Indian people in Georgia. So if you don't have connections, you cannot bring them. And there is also bribery happening. Oh, if I'm allowed to open all the cards here, I hope I can. there's a really, really huge madness happening, guys. I mean, I'm not that old enough. I'm not that experienced enough. But what I've seen in my young ages, I'm just sharing here right now. And there were much more. We had to bring people through VIP service. We used to bring such huge people. And these VIP people even had been deported. Imagine.